Hi, my name is Samson Haumba. I work for University Research Company in Swaziland. I'm the country director, and I oversee a number of projects. One of our projects deals with in-service training, and I'm here to share some lessons about improving coordination of in-service training in order to improve effectiveness, efficiency, and sustainability of training programs in the country. Just a brief background about in-service training in Swaziland. Swaziland is one of the countries in Africa that is hardest hit by the HIV epidemic. Out of every 100 women, 31% are HIV infected, and 19 men out of 100 are infected with HIV. And so the country was faced with a serious challenge of addressing HIV, both prevention and treatment and care. In-service training is one of the methods of building capacity of the healthcare workers to confidently manage patients with HIV. Since 2004, Swaziland has been implementing in-service training as a strategy to improve the capacities of the healthcare workers. However, the in-service training programs were challenged by duplication of trainings among healthcare workers, also challenged by scheduling of trainings where multiple training providers invited the same healthcare workers for different trainings at the same time. It was also challenged by service disruption. Many healthcare workers were invited for off-site trainings without adequate preparations on who will manage the patients at the health facilities. And so with all those challenges, in-service training was not effective. Neither was it done efficiently, and there were challenges around sustainability. URC, through the ASSIST project, was invited by the USAID to work with the Ministry of Health to build capacity around in-service training to improve its coordination and effectiveness. So that's the project, the work that I'm discussing here. So I'll walk you through the process and some of the results. We did a baseline assessment of the current practices around in-service training. We invited a number of stakeholders who discussed the priorities about in-service training. And what we discovered consistently was that coordination was a priority issue. We also did a formal assessment. And based on the results of the discussions and assessment, we adopted the USAID Global Framework for Workforce Development as a tool for us to implement and strengthen the in-service training coordination. The USAID framework has six components, which include coordination, include training delivery, include continuum of learning from pre-service to in-service. It also includes follow-up of learning after training, and the CPD, that's continuous professional development. The project was not able to implement all those components at a go, and so we prioritized. So these are the three things that we decided to focus on at the beginning of the project. One, the coordination mechanism. for in-service training within Swaziland. Two, the recording of in-service training or the training information system. So under the coordination piece, we worked together with the training unit of the Minister of Health, USAID and other stakeholders to develop a training coordination mechanisms, which includes the scheduling of the trainings by the various stakeholders, the approval process, and the conduct of the trainings. So what happens is that the 16 public health programs of the Ministry of Health work with their stakeholders or the training institutions to, on a quarterly basis, to identify the trainings that they need to conduct. And these trainings are then put into a calendar and submitted to the Minister of Health training unit. The Minister of Health training unit then creates the master calendar and removes duplications, removes redundancies, and submits the training calendar to the Principal Secretary and the Minister of Health. After approval of the calendar, no other training will be allowed on the calendar for that duration. So what this helps is that the managers of the various health facilities receive the calendar and they are able to schedule their staff in terms of who will attend a particular training and how it will benefit the institution. The trainings are more needs-based as opposed to previously when people were just invited for trainings. So that is the first piece, that there is a concerted effort of all the training providers and the training programs within the Ministry of Health to coordinate the trainings. The second piece which we focused on was the training information system that records, that identifies each provider, each unique trainee, so that there is no duplication of trainings. In Swaziland, many people have similar names. For instance, you will have a Temba Dlamini, and at a health facility, you have maybe 40% of the healthcare workers have the same name. Have not only one name, but both names, and even sometimes three names. And even when you try to use the date of birth, sometimes it's difficult. So this system helps us to identify each trainee as a unique person. So the training register, which we developed, has a number of variables that are able to uniquely identify the trainee. However, the beauty with the training registers that we developed and under this coordination mechanism is that a copy will remain with the training institution, a copy will be sent to the Minister of Health, and a copy will remain at the training facility. And so everyone is able to know who was trained in the previous training. The second piece associated with the register is a feedback form. After every training, the healthcare worker will go with a feedback form and is supposed to provide feedback to management about the content of the training and how they are going to do things differently from previously before the training. And so, unlike in the past where somebody would attend the training for the purpose of training, now you must link trainings to outcomes or how you're going to do things differently. The paper register also is mirrored in an electronic register, which makes life a lot easier. So I've sort of like described what we've done. But what are the key results? So we've had about 3 to 4 cycles of the quarterly planning, initially led by the project, the ASSIST project, but is now fully led by the Minister of Health. So the training office is able to manage every cycle of scheduling of the trainings, the approval process, and also the feedback process. Number two, the Minister of Health is now able to pinpoint how many trainings have happened in the country, and what were the topics, and who provided the trainings. And that empowers human resource planning. The third benefit really is that the health facilities now are able to clearly participate only in trainings that are needs-based. They do not necessarily have to send people just for the sake of sending people for trainings, but because the curriculum is, or the training schedule is sent ahead of time, you choose the appropriate person, and if you do not need the training as a health facility, then you don't need to send participants. So what have been the lessons from this work? One is that there was very little evidence or documented evidence around in-service trainings. We did literature review and we could hardly find articles around in-service training and what were the best practices. And so Swaziland had no option but to start from scratch. And so this is a system that has been developed by Swaziland working within the context of Swaziland. And it has helped to galvanize the in-service training, not only for HIV, but on all the major health problems. Number two, it has strengthened the delivery of the training itself, the training methods, but also the follow-up methods to make sure that each training is valuable and each training adds value. The coordination mechanism has also strengthened the ministry's stewardship role on human capacity development. So at the end of the day, we can conclude that in order to sustain the provision of high quality care in some of our fragile states, we need strong coordination mechanisms with clear stewardship of the Minister of Health, and all training partners are contributing to one big coordination mechanism led by the Minister of Health.